actually that letter.
They were asked in church because you speak.
Did it say it was?
Hey, Tom.
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm good.
He's in there, it's too loud.
Has to get older. I saw even this week.
One project you're actually taking on.
Thank you very much. It's like it's all we do.
Hey, how are you?
They're supposed to have a chase and then it comes home. Yeah, that's it.
Something's wrong with this. Hello.
Good to see you. Hey, John, how are you?
This is Tom Grant.
I would have done by doing my. That's okay. Welcome. Good, I'm glad to see you. Glad to meet you. Welcome aboard.
Hello. How are you doing?
Hey, how are you?
Hi.
Fairly close.
Awesome. It looks good.
That's the anniversary inset. It's going back a long way. We don't know.
Yeah.
It's probably your parents.
Oh, she
is.
The German
or something like that. I've been using my
fit
pad. I'm like going about one step. I don't need to go
I'm with you.
That's a good one. Oh, my goodness.
Okay, I'd like to call the Tuesday, May 22nd, Forsyth County Board of Commissioners work session to order at 2:01 p.m. according to that clock there. If you could all stand for the invocation and pledge, please. Father, please look down with your loving arms of protection and have a special concern for Johnny Padgett's family and all those who were involved. Johnny Padgett's a county employee who was killed in a terrible car wreck yesterday, I believe. Please protect those who put themselves in harm's way for our sake, both domestically and abroad. Help us to work together and to make good decisions on behalf of the citizens of the county. In thy holy name we pray.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
I should have also said all commissioners were present except for Commissioner Levent. All are present other than Commissioner Levent. Do we want to call Commissioner Levent only for this particular item or for the whole?
Mr. Chairman, I was going to call him as soon as we had an agreed upon agenda. Now I was going to call him in. I don't know how much time that he has.
Right.
But I know he wanted to be here.
I talked to him. He said stay as long as you could.
My concern is he might or might not want to change something on the agenda.
We can go ahead and try now. The act allows it. You want me to go ahead and try?
Yeah, please.
Yeah, we got it. Jim?
All right. Okay.
You got a copy of it?
I don't know. But you may want to ask.
You might have it on your back.
Todd?
Hello?
Todd?
Yeah.
Can you hear us? This is Jim Boff.
Hey.
Hey, we're just about to adopt or make modifications and then adopt the agenda. We thought we should get you on in case there was anything you wanted to change. So we'll go ahead with the adoption of the agenda if that's okay.
Chairman, just to confirm, Commissioner Levent, where are you? Yes, we have the jurisdiction. Is the rule. Where are you right now?
Kansas.
That's out of the jurisdiction.
Somewhere here, Jeff Johnson, Kansas.
All right. Well, at this, why don't we adopt the agenda? Are there any changes? Are there any changes to the agenda?
Chairman, I have a couple for your consideration. One is to ask the board to add a time-sensitive item. Asking to add as item number two, and that is for the board to consider a change order for additional design work to be done for the South Parks. Item number two.
We need a vote on that, Ken?
Yes, sir. It needs to be a motion and second and four-fifths.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Those like sign, that carries unanimously. What else?
I've got one other item for your consideration. Ask you to consider moving item seven. It's a request approval for proposed operating hours and fees for Old Atlantis Parade Park to item three.
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 All those opposed, like sign. That passes unanimously. Any other changes?
Kristen, are you here for item that the staff should be here for other issues?
I'm here for other issues.
Do you want me to move that? Because you're not involved in
that. The text will not
work.
Not addressing that.
So I hear a motion to adopt the agenda.
Mr. Chairman, I have one. Forgive me. I would respectfully request that the board postpone item number 18 until the June 12th work session. Mr. Chairman, that will take a motion and second.
Second. Second.
We have a motion and a second for item 18. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes unanimously. Chair would entertain a motion to adopt the agenda as amended.
About 15? Josh, you want to cut from that?
I'll leave it up to Ken.
Yeah, I think we're prepared to go forward on that, Mr. Commissioner.
Anyone wishing to make?
Next motion, put the agenda as amended.
Second. Where was number eight? Where was number 18, Cindy?
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, like sign. That passes unanimously. And we're on then to item number one.
And previous recusals will stand as noted.
True. Our recusal set at this time for the vote and discussion on the water issue.
Thank you.
Pete Amos. Commissioner, District 1. Go ahead.
I think it would be helpful if we could.
Mr. Chairman, just one, I'm sorry. Is there enough space for everybody? I just need to make sure that if people are looking for space to sit.
How many do we have out here?
I think there's two, I think there's two of us.
And we've got a couple up here, staff can sit up at the table.
Okay.
Come on, Emma.
Y'all are jumping out of here too quick.
I'm going to use this on. Where's your chair? Let's start to sit right here. Right chair there. Do we need any other chairs? Dave, tell me, need any more? Anybody else out there?
Okay, let's continue then.
I thought it would be helpful if we could take the latest proposal from the city and maybe if you have it on a spreadsheet, Tam, you could show it to us and then we could see, could we just talk dollars about what their proposal is over 10 years, Tam?
Can you see the screen up there?
You're going to have to verbalize really good.
What I have, since I just got this morning, that I had tried to create something from the last offer and in the dollars, I didn't see a change in the cost for raw water. It was tiered and the finished water cost, I believe, is the same. We can make changes. And so what you have here is what I created from the last offer. And it did have an amount that was specified to finished water that talked about before you would go to the next tier. And so I'm unable to say because of not, well, I really can't find in here a required finished water amount. I see the numbers referenced, but I don't see that you have to do it, so that could change it.
Minimum requirement.
And I can't find a minimum requirement in what I saw this morning. But I had the number from
$1.2 billion.
$1.215,450 is what I remember last time.
Okay.
So I've got that in here, and I've got it all at the.
And you have it on CPI, though, don't you?
I do have it on CPI.
Okay.
And that's this, this here is the, and this was, how many years will we be buying that amount?
Well, the proposal's five.
Okay, I've got 5 years in here.
All right, so add five more.
Starts at 220. Add five more?
No, not finished, but 5 years. I'm trying to get to the total.
Okay.
That looks like you have it highlighted in bold there, is that right?
Okay, this would be the what we would treat, and this is at your base. And we started out with this same number. It worked out. So the first year, all of the water would be within that base raw water amount at 50 cents. Mm-hmm. And the way this works, the second year, you take the total amount, subtract what we're going to buy from the city. The remainder is what we'll treat. And then so then I take the base and subtract that out. So I say that we'll have 133,590,000 gallons above the base, and that's at the 75 cents per thousand on raw water. So then moving over, just like the other sheets work, there's your raw water cost between the two at these rates.
Okay.
Then we get into our normal screens. I've got some of these minimized for our cost to produce. Now in here, I believe it includes, and Dave, Gruen can help me if I'm wrong, that we're going to make a payment for the intake of 1.4. And so I think before you told me to spread that over out over 10 years, if it was a 10-year contract. So I've put 1.1 4 million per year over 10 years in this, if we spread it out over the life of that. You may tell me to change that.
Jim, what do we get for that money?
We get the use of, well, I guess that's...
Read the verbiage on what they sent over when it describes what we get for that.
Todd, if I could, I'm just, he's going across on the spreadsheet. If we could just get to what the total dollar amount is first. This is what I'm trying to get to.
Okay.
Over
so,
10 years, the county will spend on water.
Okay. What I have here, because it works the same way, is comparing to the current contract. So this is the total cost to purchase and treat water, $6.96 million. There's the payment to the city. This is the difference in the current contract.
Okay.
And this offer. So it's an additional expense of $1.2 million. And then here's your cumulative changes.
Okay, so at the year, at the end of year 10, which is, I lost my place down the line. Is that number 32?
Let me just get down to right there. Right there. The 29, I think. That should be this 10. That's 10 years there. Can I just did a photo? So I made that thought.
Why don't you hide 30 through whatever?
Okay.
Can you tell me, since I can't see the screen, what is the finished water 225 and is the raw water amount that they're wanting us to start paying? Is it 45 cents starting?
It's 50 cents.
50.
50 cents, okay, thank you.
And the finished water is
225.
With no CPI.
With a CPI.
Is or is not?
Yes.
Okay, thank you.
Does everybody have a copy of the proposal set across?
Okay.
So Tim, do I understand? If I'm getting too far ahead, tell me. But do I understand that this results in an increase?
Yes.
7.485 million?
Yes.
Over 10 years?
Yes.
All right. So that's what's ahead of us right now. That's what's in front of us. 7.5 increase over 10 years based on this current proposal.
And Tim, I'm sorry, can you say again, is this based on the assumption we do have to buy finished water, or we
this
don't?
Is based on the assumption that we will buy for 5 years this 1.215 billion gallons, which is on average 3.33 million gallons per day. The extra that we need, we'd be able to treat ourselves, is the way this works, if that's not the case.
All right, so this $7.5 million increase, that includes the payment of $11.4 million.
It does.
I'm trying to speak loud so Todd can hear me.
That's why you see a change over here after these two things. After, well, you're not looking past 10 years, but you'd start to see a change. One, you see a change when we start treating all of our own water after 5. If we can treat all of our own water, we start to see positive. And then there's a big change after 10 when the spreading out of that intake payment goes away.
Okay.
And these are positive numbers after 10. But eventually it goes negative again.
All right. That's what I wanted to see. I don't know if you want to see something else, but do you have on this, without doing away with that, so we can come back and reference it, we talked about a rate study that gets sent out?
Yeah, that's out.
Yeah, we did some comparisons, yes, sir.
Residential, I mean, rate residential.
There was one bar graph I thought was interesting to point out.
And I have these, I believe they loaded them on the screen. If you want me to try to put any of them up on the screen, I can try to do so.
Which one was it?
Patrick, does that you rattling the papers on purpose again?
We are.
Me? No, Todd. Can you not hear?
Yeah. You want me?
I think it'd be...
Which one is it?
You don't have it. Residential commercial comparison. Do you have that one that we can show up there?
Now, you do a comparison as retail or one in a government agreement to another municipality selling it?
No, it's the rates that customers pay, so retail, if you will.
Okay. And the purpose of bringing this up, showing this?
I just want to
I'll have to open
point out where we stand.
Okay. And have we done a rate study to show what's normal and usual for our area between the municipalities?
Wholesale water, yes.
They're not named in here. They're just in this file. So,
hit or miss.
No, they're not.
That's a graph right there.
You know which one this would?
That's residential. You just opened.
Is this the graph? Is this what we're looking for?
No, right, well, that was going to be the second one I wanted to see. So that's perfectly fine if we want to take that in that order.
Okay.
All right. Just kind of, can you give us a little breakdown on that one?
This is information that came from a cooperative effort from GIFA, where they survey water systems throughout the state, and they create this dashboard. So you can go in at any time and compare your rates to anybody else. You can break it down multiple ways. You can break it down by basin, by size, by, you know, a lot of different ways. So this was just
came from here, too. I'm sorry.
That's correct. Oh, that's the Metro District survey? Okay.
Is that the spreadsheets that we sent out?
No, we sent out GIFA stuff.
This is GIFA, yeah.
Yeah. Okay, but this came from the Metro District?
No, that came from GIFA.
This is GIFA. Yeah, all these people are not in the Metro District. So it was, right, we used the GIFA. It's the most up-to-date. It was more current through, I believe, the end of 2011. And so this is just a plot of all of the rates that they have for 7,000 gallons of water. And this is just a gathering of some of the systems that are similar and in our area. To compare where we sit with our current rates, which is highlighted in the dark green, on finished water rates for 7,000 gallons.
And so, if I'm counting this correctly, there are 26 different groups, suppliers of water, if you will, and we're number 8. There are 18 higher than us. Seven lower.
I didn't count them, so.
But, well, I just did that in about 30 seconds, so I might.
That looks to be kind of correct. 1, 2, 3, 7.
Right.
10.
10.
Looks like 10. It's hard to say where this one falls.
I did it on the slide, too. So
I know Cherokee's a little higher than us, so.
6.
I think I count 9 below us now. Can I double check? Get a nod over there. 9 below us,
and then we
17 above us, or 16 above us.
Are you trying to clarify that our water rates to our customers are very fair now?
No, I'm just trying to go through. I'm just trying to show a bunch of slides because you're not here.
Yeah, you're going to have to control that. But anyways,
I just think it's
which would further show why we need to try to stay as close to something that we have now or less than, so we can say it as a.
Well, I think that's a good point.
Go to the, Tim, open another slide.
Residential and commercial comparison slide.
Just hover over.
I think it's this one.
And first of all.
Yeah, that's it. That might be the.
And I just want to go ahead and, Tim, I appreciate you doing all this.
Well,
Tim, Doug, Dave, Carol, Cindy. I know you guys have other business to come before the board, maybe, but they put a lot of work into this stuff. I think it's relevant information. Todd, I think you hit the nail on the head. We need to stay. We don't need to lessen our position. Is that right?
No, that's not what I said. I just don't want to pay more for water than we do now so that we can maintain our reasonable rates for our customers.
That's what I was trying to say.
In a nutshell. This particular slide has both commercial. They're the same information there at commercial rates based on 25,000 gallons. So you can see, we just looked at the residential at 7,000. This is in dollars, and you can see where we fall on the same on commercial review.
Okay, so why? Just out of curiosity, why is Lumpkin County so high for commercial? And Roswell, so why are they so high for commercial?
No.
I just wondered what the thinking is there.
They're paying for new reservoir.
They're paying for, the commercial people are paying for the new reservoir so the residents don't have to?
Well, Lumpkin's non-residential is also the highest on the page.
No.
The residential and?
Yeah.
For the
reservoir. That's what we ought to do is get a reservoir and then we can do the highest on the page.
They're $90.
Okay. So we're in pretty good shape there too, right Tim?
Correct.
Okay. Can you go back to the spreadsheet? Can you hear okay, Todd?
I can. Okay. I can't speak too good though.
I understand.
That's normal.
Listen, just vote the way we tell you to, okay?
I'll have to think about that.
Why don't you copy that to a new sheet?
How are you going to get off fancy?
No, you didn't have to do that, Tim. Go back.
Do you want?
Just make copy? Yeah, just go back to home.
Here.
It's actually a spreadsheet.
Yeah. Oh, the spreadsheet. I'm sorry.
Go to the spreadsheet.
Okay.
Let's make copies.
Go home. Changes. Make home.
Okay.
Okay. And then just right click on the tab at the bottom. City offer 5-8.
Oh, okay. Yeah, they'll copy it like that. Just when you tab
it, just right
sheet.
Click and
right. Copy
and then create a copy. That's one now.
That's why we won't change.
Yeah, that way we'll change that one.
And it's got two on it, right? Yeah.
So we can change this one.
We can change that
one. All right, let's change this one to. I mean, let's try to change this one to. I didn't. What is the final number? I wrote down 7.5 increase. But does anybody have a total? Do you have a cumulative total on there?
7.5.
Oh, that's cumulative savings.
That's cumulative. Well,
it's a cost savings.
I've got. I mean, I can add up. We can use any of these for.
Can I ask you, James, something?
Yes.
Are you doing this because you're contemplating voting to accept the offer from the city of Cumming?
No, I'm not prepared to accept
the
offer.
Okay.
I think we're trying. I think we're trying to establish what it does to our position now over the next 10 years. So, if it's a $7.5 million increase, I don't think we want to do that. We want to try to.
I know we don't want to.
So
why are we going to respectfully vote and reject that, and come up with something you want to live with?
Well, that's what I think.
All at one time.
I think we're doing that now on this spreadsheet.
Okay.
We plug in the numbers. That's why I'm trying to get a total number over to the side. You know, we can shoot out a number like 47 cents a thousand or 221 a thousand or whatever. What does it do to the total over the next 10 years? That's what I'm trying to do.
And are you comfortable with a 10 year or do you want to ask for more?
I think we start with 10 years.
And then let it reset so we don't, because we've seen that CPI gets climbing too much. It needs a reset after 10.
Didn't we send them something over that reset after 15 on the 16th year?
I believe we did.
But it was the raw water.
Yeah, raw water.
county ballot.
Well, let's start with 10 and then.
All right, well, let's just start with this 10 if we can. It just seems.
Would you like to, I mean, this is a number you can reference as you make changes.
Go ahead, I got it written down, 7.5 maybe.
Okay. Yeah, I know what it is.
I don't know what the total is, but.
That's a total payment or?
No, total, but commutes, okay. All right, that's fine.
I could add down.
Could you add that down?
That one?
Yeah.
That'll be the sum of the payments to the city.
Don't add that, okay. All right, well, that's fine.
Okay.
It's the cumulative on the water.
Yeah, we've got 7.5. That's what this does to our current water deals, it costs $7.5 million.
More than what we pay now.
More than what we pay now. Let's find a way where we don't do that. Where we don't pay more than we do now.
I want to pay less.
Okay, then let's find a way to pay less.
Okay. About to start with 11.4.
Well, that's easy.
Amortizing that every 10 years still.
That saves us $4 million.
So do we take that out?
If we're not getting ownership, I'd love to take it out.
I would agree. Plus, I think the wording was wordsmithed to where we wouldn't like it. I think it reads up to 65% and doesn't guarantee a 65%. It's just up to.
Well, I think it's up to depending on what the permit levels are for both. And wait a minute, Todd. I think it also included language that the city would provide raw water off of their permit until we got ours increased.
Well, and that's fine, but it needs to make sure that it gives us 65%, not up to.
Well, we don't get 65% of today's water. We get up to 65%.
Well, it just needs to be written more clearly then, because right now.
Ken can handle
it. We've got a guy that can do that.
We got a guy that can write anything.
Okay. Makes up words.
All right, take the 11.4 out. I shouldn't say it like that, Tim. I didn't mean it that way. I'm sorry.
You know, if you do have a guy that can write what we need, if he goes in the bathroom and does it, don't blame each other for that. You have trust in him.
I'm not sure we followed you on that, Todd.
Is that mountain air in Kansas?
It's thin.
Is it mountain air in Kansas?
Thin air.
Thin air.
There's flat air.
It's
flat
air
in
Kansas.
In the truck?
All right, so that saves us $3.9 million if you just take the 11.4 out of this current proposal.
You guys know where I stand on this. I'm not interested in starting out at $57,000 on raw water when we're paying 10 cents today.
What do you want to start at?
Well, I think we're staying
there. Yeah, but if you're paying 50 cents a thousand and it satisfies any upgrade in infrastructure.
We have no risk with it.
To be quite honest, the last proposal that I voted on, we all voted on the same thing, was a little higher than I wanted to send that over to begin with. Anything higher than that, I'm not interested in voting on it in favor of it.
In what? As finished water or? Raw water or upgrade to the improvements?
The raw water.
The raw water?
Yeah, the finished water that we get at a 5 and 5 at 225 a thousand, I was comfortable with.
All right, we reduced that by 10%. You know that, right?
To what number exactly?
We've reduced it down to 225.
I understand that. I absolutely do. So, I have a comfort zone with that.
Okay.
But for raw water that we sent over there at 30,000, and then reset it at 16, you're down to 20, I was very comfortable with that. Actually, a little bit more than I wanted to give. Anything greater than that, I'm not interested.
Okay.
Well, Todd, I think you have to weigh something that you might not have known, but the city rejected that offer.
I do know that. You know that. That doesn't mean they're being fair and reasonable.
It doesn't. Well, I understand that, but what it tells you is, you know, I don't think we can send over an offer that's lower.
I don't think so either.
I'm not sure. I wish we could. I know we're trying to get them to pay us to take the order.
Is it possible that you could tell us exactly what it is that they will accept, so we don't play the games back and forth every week?
I don't know what that number is.
I certainly don't know, Todd, this is Jim.
My question was posed to you, Chairman.
For what?
I don't think my question was directly to Chairman.
Okay.
He can't participate, he's a timeout.
Well, that would be Pete, yeah. Well, I mean, we're going to be sitting here again for a long, long period of time.
What we're going to end up...
I'm just trying to tell you now, anything more than the last offer, I'm going to vote against it. I think we raised him up quite a bit, I think we're being very fair. I thought his concerns were being covered in the interpro, they want a little bit more money. I just wish we knew what that magic number was, and I wish they had sent that over to us. Because what they sent, obviously, they had to have known we were going to reject.
Okay.
So being with the final hour, I wish they had sent over what they would accept it. And we could have been done with this already.
Well, if we don't counter, Todd, the fact is, that I don't know what's going to happen. It's either going to go to $1,000, as they've said, or they're going to leave it in place. But that puts us at $1.6 million a year at $250. They're going to end up making more money just leaving it like it is. It's a win for them to leave it alone.
Let's be clear. Right.
That's an interesting concept.
Let's be clear.
If they left it like it is, I'm not so sure I would challenge that right away. I don't know if that's...
How would you challenge something that we've been in agreement with for over 20 years?
That's correct. The only thing you could possibly challenge is that we have a plan now that can service the needs that we have. And thank you, but no, thank you, we don't need that service from you anymore. We just need raw water. But we're going to have to purchase something, as I understand.
I don't think that's reasonable. It goes back to, you know, you get dangerously close to not having enough raw water or finished water.
Exactly.
I understand.
And that's worse, Todd, than, you know, saving a little money and not having enough water.
And I'm contemplating that because you've got your developments in the future. I understand we've got secure.
I mean, if you think about it,
Now that we realize how much more he was asking for over our present contract.
Yeah.
And apparently Commissioner Bell and Commissioner Tam were most in tune with this.
He said it.
And they must have helped get to bring it forward, which is good.
He said it publicly,
but
Todd.
What is it that you all would like to propose that we do as a county?
Well, that's what we're working on right now.
All right.
I mean, that's what we're working on. We established...
I understand, but y'all are... I don't think you have to fluff it so much. I think you could just probably go there if you want to.
You know, the mayor did say that today that this was essentially a cost-plus situation. If we really want to find out the cost and then figure out what the plus is, we'd have to get the numbers from the city, and then find out what...
I have to tell you, if we could hire one or two firms that would come in and don't have any partiality in the county or the city, and could run us some real numbers that's normal and reasonable...
We've got that from GIFA.
What's normal and reasonable?
Yeah.
We've got that from GIFA, Todd.
Yeah, I heard what you were looking at.
Well, it came from GIFA. It came from the state. That's a independent.
But you're talking about retail. I'm not talking about retail.
We got cost.
Okay.
Well, I mean, this isn't the same. The mayor said it's a cost-plus situation, but we don't know his cost and we don't know his plus. As soon as he said it was a cost-plus situation, it doesn't really matter what it costs in Fulton County. It'd be nice to know what his costs are and what his percentage plus is.
Because we want to, okay, let me ask you something. So are you saying that if his cost is 50 cents a thousand, just thinking out loud, and are you comfortable paying $2 a thousand so that his profit is, or that their incremental
margin
is $1.50?
Uh, be comfortable in discussing that.
Or is it $1.25 or is it a dollar? What is the figure?
I don't know. Tell me his cost and tell me his percent.
I don't know.
Tell me the percent he's looking for.
I don't know.
Okay.
But I can tell you the costs change over time. Right now, I think the costs are getting ready to go up as the lake is going down and you have more sediment in the water. It costs more money to treat the water. I don't think the costs are the same every day. But I'm trying to establish, is there a margin that is acceptable? Because if there is, then that's what we should be driving to. What I'm trying to drive to is say, look, they just sent over an offer that increases our usage over the our cost over the next 10 years of $7.5 million. Let's counter back. And I mean, the simplest thing, if you want to stop right now, as Patrick said, was take the 11.4 out. Then we've got a $4 million reduction in our water costs. And we've taken out the tier that they proposed on both the raw and the finished water. That saves us $4 million.
Well, the only thing that changed was the tiers didn't reduce anything. Right.
Then what cost us more?
Well, they might have.
They definitely would have.
They had it in there.
I thought the full $4 million was reduced by the removal of the 11 million.
And no tiers.
Okay, I missed that point, so.
Right, Tim?
Sir?
You don't have any tiers in this, do you?
Finished water?
No, raw?
Neither.
Raw has a tier.
Take the tier out. Where's the tier?
Everything above that.
I'm sorry, in the finished water, is there a tier?
Finished water, no, because I don't know how.
Right.
I don't know how much we're going to need.
What did they say, 340 or something, Ken?
It would go to 350, I believe.
Just take that out.
It's out.
We're not going
to
do that.
I didn't know how to model that, so.
Go to raw water. We don't want a tier on that either, I don't believe.
But my point is, or what I was trying to get out of you is, what is the acceptable margin? And I'm not going to sit in for them. That makes you comfortable.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not like they're taking distribution checks here. They put it back into the system. What's the comfortable margin? And then is our margin the same? I mean, if they're making, let's just say, $1.10 a thousand gallons, should we be making $1.11 or $1.09?
I think I'll make it the same.
Because we make money too.
I'm gonna make this the same.
We're in debt. We don't make money. We mark the thing up, but that's not the same as profit. We have a lot of overhead and a lot of expenses
so
too.
Do they.
Yeah, but you're going along with him in which the fact that he's come up with this number, I don't know where it came from, and said he said $16 million today. That's profit.
I don't know where that is.
We don't make any profit.
Well, we do.
We don't. We mark the water up in order to cover our costs. In fact, we just had to raise the rates a couple of years ago because we weren't making enough.
But we also put away for capital projects. That's what we have money in the bank to continue to do. That's what they do with theirs. So our profit is no different than their profit. Any money that we get goes towards investing in the system. Okay, go ahead.
Was it three?
7.360217.
The tier on raw water.
Todd, by removing the tier on the raw water, it's a savings of almost $7.4 million.
Then, are you savings off of what? Off of what he offered?
Off what their counter is. If we set this back.
It's more than that off of their offer. This is off of the current contract. You have to add the negative seven off of their offer.
It's almost $15 million.
Right, because the original their offer was
Well, let's see if we can get some more.
Well, can't we just get it where they'll pay us? You know, again, I still maintain, and I've said it over and over again, if the board does not get past worrying about how much the city makes and are we providing water to our citizens at a good rate?
I'm going back to saying, you're talking about it, or some people are talking about it like they're taking profit in a distribution in a paycheck and putting it in their pocket. Anything they make in their system is the same as anything they make in our system, and it's reinvested.
Well,
they're just more mature. They're more mature than we are. They've been at it longer, so they've paid off more of their debt.
That's the Commissioner Boff just said we don't make a profit, yet they do.
I didn't say they did.
Do they make a profit?
I don't know. That's why I asked for the audit.
Well, wait a minute. They had an audit in 2004.
A forensic audit.
In 2004, they had a forensic audit.
Okay, and so what was their burden cost?
8 years ago?
I don't know. Was I supposed to bring that to the meeting?
Well.
No, look.
Can I ask one question?
Come on.
Todd, I'll ask you, because you're looking out the window. What's the date today?
7/12.
Today's the 22nd, isn't it? May 22nd?
I mean, if you look hard enough, you can find a reason not to vote.
That's the main point. Just because the city says I'm going to vote 10 times on raw water if you don't agree to what I want you to pay me, and that is what causes the date to expire, it's not our fault.
Well, I believe it is.
It's our responsibility.
Because we're looking at a calculation here that saves the taxpayers of this county $15 million over 10 years.
$15 million.
And that's not good enough.
Why don't we look at the original contract that we have right now?
The one I brought to the board in 2006?
That's Charlie didn't want that one.
Y'all stop already?
You're
10 cents a thousand on raw, and you're $250 a thousand on finished. And all we're doing is asking not to buy as much.
This is seven million savings over the current contract. This is a $7 million savings over the current contract.
All savings, all you want.
Let him finish.
The
numbers don't lie.
The numbers are right here on the screen. Hold on. And it's a $15 million swing from the offer that they sent over, and a $7.4 million savings over the current contract. Now, what I'm telling you is, we know that on the 26th, one of two things is going to happen. We're either going to continue on the contract that we're on, or they're going to raise raw water to a dollar. I have no idea what it's going to be, but the fact is, in the figures, as we're looking right here, is this is a savings.
So what is the number?
We're already providing some of the lowest water in Georgia.
What is the number you want to get to? You got a $14 million savings. Does it need to be 20, 25, 30? What's it got to be?
Well, what number do you want to get to?
I'm comfortable with this.
Well, you said let's see what else we can save. So what do you have in mind?
Why don't you give some input, Commissioner Boff? You've not given any input in all these meetings.
I think you're saying the offer back over again than when we said last time.
Okay.
That is more than I even want to give them.
Okay.
So you're making a motion to send over the offer that was rejected this morning?
Or left there what we gave them last time.
Well, now that's an interesting way to look at it.
Well,
I'm going to make a motion.
I was a very hard pressed to offer that. I was trying to answer Jenna's. I thought that'd be something that would be actually welcome. It's an extremely reasonable, small party aspect. Any more than that, I don't think I can vote for it.
Okay, can I say something?
Sure.
I'm going to make a motion that we send this over.
Well,
I'm going to say it here in just a second.
Okay.
Tim, can you slide over to the right so I guess we can reference this? All right. This offer to the city coming at $225,000, no CPI, right, Tim?
This has CPI. Yes.
I'm sorry. Slide over one more time.
$225,000.
No tier. Thank you very much.
$225,000. For how many gallons?
1.2 billion required.
Is there a pay daily thing, or can we use it when we need it?
No, that changed in their offer anyway. So, that's a good question, though. Is that forward?
Sorry.
Is that a motion?
No. 1.2 billion gallons, 225, no tiers, with CPI, raw water, 50 cents. No tiers, CPI, no 11.4,
up to
65%. Ken, you're nodding your head. Am I missing something?
No, sir.
Okay.
Raw water shared on their permit if needed.
They'll go downtown with us holding hands to try to get our permit increased. Based on the spreadsheet that Tim's got, line number 29 saves 7.360 million plus, Tim, how much more?
7.5.
7.5 more, so saves us over $15 million.
Well, $15 million off of what they sent out.
7.3 off the current. Says it's $500,000 a year. Or more than half, it's $750,000 a year.
Oh, man. I think you have a motion or a second, Chairman.
It's out there.
Yeah. Who seconded it? I'm sorry.
Well, Todd did, I think.
Commissioner Bell did. Bell's a good try.
I mean, if you don't want this, what do you want?
Yeah.
Let me ask you a question. When you said the offer, you said you sent an offer over, and you wanted to send it over again. How much did it say?
Your raw water should be no more than double what it is today.
Based on what?
Oh, and no obligation to pay the 11.4. I don't know if I said
that. Does that not include?
So what is your bottom line dollar? I mean, that you're saving. Tell me what your savings are in your proposal.
Why do you have to look at it that way? That's a ridiculous way of looking at it.
How much we're saving the taxpayers?
No, you have to put smoke and mirrors up by using those words. If we're paying 10 cents a thousand now, and you want to give them 50 cents a thousand, you just increased it by 500%.
No, but we're decreasing the net cost.
And you call that a savings in the same breath.
Because we're looking at all of the facts, Todd, not just part
right.
of
you're look, you're,
all of the facts show a savings.
You're reducing the cost of finished water, right? I mean, that's a given. You only have a five-year obligation to buy it. Can I finish? Can I finish? You only have a five-year obligation to buy it.
And it's only 1.2 versus 1.6.
Right. So you're buying less for less money.
2 months ago, you were arguing that we need to establish a long-term water contract for the stability of our county.
But you didn't want to do that.
5 years.
Well, if you want to go longer, I'd be happy to amend the motion.
No, because I'm not going for that dollar figure. But go ahead.
Well, then what is your dollar figure?
Let's call the vote.
What is your dollar figure?
I tried to tell you, but you don't want to hear it. You know what?
No, we do want to hear it. Your dollar figure.
What is the savings you want to present?
In numbers.
Stop with this word savings in your smoke and mirrors.
It's not smoke and mirrors, Todd.
Everything that Commissioner Tam offered I can live with, except the 50 cents per thousand overall, make it 20 and I'll consider it.
That's less than what we sent over last time, Todd.
You pulled out paying for the infrastructure just now, Mr. Bell.
We didn't offer to pay. We just set out last time.
Counselor, I would just like a
moment. You asked me what I would do, and I just told you.
Okay,
you have
thank
a
you.
Mute button on that thing. I'd like just a moment to go to just confirm with Tim, just to make sure that I'm right. Could we take a short break? Is that appropriate? Let me shift with a. Most
of the appropriate if the board will
I just don't want to make a mistake here.
Sure.
Okay.
Now, 10 minutes. Okay, and just make sure procedurally, we have a motion and a second pending.
Right.
I'm okay with that because in the term of meeting, that's fine.
All right.
We're going to take a 5 minute break.
Five minute break would be good, probably. 5 or 10. We always switch them.
Hey Todd, we want us to call you back in a few minutes. Todd,
are y'all taking a break?
Yeah, we're gonna take a break, so we'll call you back in a few minutes.
That way we can save the money on the phone bill.
Yeah, please do. Thank you.
Hey, stop and get you a Coca Cola and some peanuts.
We got anything else to add to this?
No.
Okay, I got it.
And I'll be at the commissioner's meeting.
Next.
They took you out. I'm going to go to the next one.
down, so we offer that.
Yeah, that's the biggest difference.
That's close. No, you have to.
Yeah, I felt terrible.
So you're up and running. You got an email.
You have to wonder what did they bid off. Maybe it is those, I don't know. But the Lumpkin kind of water and sewer series.
Well, Lumpkin has a population of what? I mean, there's probably under 20,000.
I was going to say, is it 19?
Yeah.
9 acre lots or something like that.
So the tax base is that small.
They just have fewer customers, which makes the price per customer slight.
Yeah, you're right. There are probably a lot of wells.
I'm sure there's still a lot.
God, I remember being on a well. Had a beautiful farmhouse with a really nice well to my neighbor something new with my wife. He used to complain about his mother. He sucked a new one with him. Fine, dry.
Damn.
I said we needed a chart where yours was what we rank right now. We should have done a chart of what the mayor proposed, and then where did we fall? Then you're looking at where we are now to where he proposed.
Yeah, we don't really know how to, what we'll have to do with rights to this.
Okay, I'd like to call the meeting back to order after our 5 minute break.
20 minutes ago?
Yeah, about 20 minutes ago. It's now 7 minutes after 3. Is Todd back on the phone? Or is he still on the phone? Thank you.
Hello?
Hey, you there?
Yeah.
Okay, we're back. We just came back. Tim, I have a question for you. In your spreadsheet, how hard would it be?
Do you have to call the meeting back to order or not?
I already did. Thanks.
Okay, thank you.
In your spreadsheet, is it set up right now as it was when we went on break that shows the $7 million?
Yes.
Okay. Is it, how hard is it would be to change the beginning number on the raw water to 40 cents rather than 50, which is where we are now?
Keep in mind, if for some strange reason that this does end up in court and you offer more than the 10 cents, that you're setting a standard in which you what you'll accept, Mr. Boss.
Yeah. So you see, that looks to me like it's $5 million better for every time you do a dime. Probably every time you do a dime, there's $5 million to be gained there.
Can I, before we get too far down the road, I asked to meet with Tim, and I just want to add something to my motion. I see you.
Well, why don't you have the second be withdrawn and restated?
Cindy, you'll have to help me with the motion. Go ahead. My motion, and I'm going to add the change to it first, is that in this contract they make an additional 6.5 million gallons a day on a monthly average available to us, 50% finished and 50% raw at our request.
Say that again.
Todd, I'm not convinced we're going to have enough water. So if we request more, they will supply us up to, I did this before, 6.5 million gallons a day on a monthly, on a 30-day average, half of it finished, half of it raw.
Okay, I got you.
Okay?
At the same rates.
No tiers, none of that stuff.
This is 6.5 million
a day on a 30-day average. Projections show, Tim Perkins pipe in, but 5 years from now, we could very well need that. We need to make sure that we have enough water.
Okay, well, if we do that, what does that mean to the price?
Well, it's no requirement.
It's just
going to be there if we need it.
Okay. So do we spend more? Sure, but we should be taking in more.
Yes, I just wanted to make
it's
sure.
It's just a safety net. So then my motion would be to reference this spreadsheet that we offer $225 for the finished 1.2 billion commitment, CPI but no tiers, and then on the raw, 50 cents a thousand, CPI but no tiers. And Cindy, I don't know, did I leave anything off my last motion?
The same language.
No, 11.4,
and in these payments, the 11.4 is satisfied. Satisfied. Recognize as satisfied, not 10 years from now you still owe us this. I'm saying recognize as satisfied. So that it's not just kicked down the road.
And then the 65% capacity.
65, yeah. Similar, like, counselors, and more language that we need to put in this?
Put in the duration.
65% capacity. They'll go downtown with us holding hands, all that stuff.
Yeah.
And the duration is 5 for finished and 10 for raw?
5 finished, 10 for raw. That's my motion.
Give me the time frame one more time, please.
5 year on the finish, and the finish has been all along with an option for 5 more.
Okay, fair enough.
And then the raw is 10 years.
Let's do an option for 10. Let's go reset it.
Okay.
We might have our own 5 minutes.
So that's my motion.
Second.
I'm going to make an amendment to your motion. By amendment to your motion, it would take the raw water for 20 years, and the amount that we pay is 20 cents a thousand, and still no tiers.
I just don't think that's going to go, Todd. You're saving $15 million.
And it's less than
to
what we
point. Why don't you just, again, ask him to give it to us for free?
Gentlemen, I used to watch C-SPAN when I had extra time in my life, and I used to watch the Democrats in Washington argue about how much they're going to save instead of the true increased cost in reality.
I'm looking at a spreadsheet that shows a savings of 7.57
That's what the conservative Democrats have been wanting as well.
No, it's not a smoke and mirrors because the contract that we have is over in 4 days. So a renewed contract with a new contract and this proposed rate that is a savings over the current contract of $7.3 million.
Excuse me.
You heard my amendment.
I don't think you got a second.
Okay, excuse me just for a second. Mr. Perkins, Mr. Gruen, do you think these figures are accurate? Do you mind?
Yeah, I think they're accurate. I mean, I've had people look at it, looking for mistakes or errors. It's comparing current contract. The only thing that could change that is with no tiers on the finished water, it wouldn't change. But that extra water is not modeled in any way. This is based on the 1.2, us finishing the rest, and the raw water cost. So the changes we just made are not in this model, but it wouldn't be easy to do.
Are you?
That's the extra water we need.
Do you think you're comfortable with this proposal? Do you think it's an improvement? Are you have anything you'd like to add?
My only comment would be based, comparing to the current contract. You got your numbers right here comparing to the current contract, and I can't say what you can get through.
I think that's all right.
Try one more time.
But you think they're accurate to satisfy?
Yes, I mean, they're. It's not. You're not going to be able to put this in the books for next year's budget because it's a half year stuff. We're dealing with whole year's
numbers. It's not smoke and mirrors.
Numbers. No, it's not smoke and mirrors. It's the best effort we've got to calculate cost, verify cost where we could.
Well, I think it's a no anyway. We've got a motion and a second.
Actually, Ken, what do we do? And then he was in the middle of a motion.
Well, I don't think it matters, Mr. Chairman. I just went and quick look at the rule. Here's what I understood his motion to amend was to change the raw to 20 years and to change the rate to 20 cents per thousand.
That's not an amendment.
Yeah, Commissioner Tam's motion was setting a specific rate for the raw of, I think, 50 cents per thousand. So that amendment would, in effect, negate or defeat the primary motion on the table. So I think that's out of order.
Okay. Then I would like to make an amendment. Sorry, give me a second. And that is that this offer include 65% of the water storage allocation from the Corps of Engineers.
They can't control that.
We get 65% of their storage allocations for us.
What's the difference, Ken? What he's saying versus what language do we have in
there? I'm back.
All right. Okay. Hang on just a minute.
What we have right now, if you're telling me to sort of embrace the previous language we'd used about we get any future allocation at 65% based upon the North Metro, we didn't discuss the core. So that would be a function where we would probably just need to expand the language such that the city and county would work together to the extent that the core is receptive to those sorts of offers to also seek an allocation
city
out
of. City can't authorize.
They can ask
him. Right, we can ask him.
All right, well, look, hold on. Todd's back. Todd?
Yeah.
Well, while you were gone, Ken explained that your motion couldn't, or your amendment couldn't be used because it defeated the main motion. And so that's one thing that happened. The other thing that happened is that I've made an amendment to the motion this offer includes what I said was 65% of the water storage capacity, that's not the right, water storage allocation, thank you, from the Corps of Engineers. And we were discussing that the city really can't control the percentage that the Corps of Engineers would grant, but we can ask that they, what's the word I'm looking there, participate or encourage or promote, cooperate.
We can cooperate.
Request that we go with the 65% water storage allocation.
It should kind of go hand in hand with the intake allocation as that grows, so to speak.
I don't care. I hear that. That's good stuff. Now, what about the 20 cents a thousand?
Commissioner Levent, I'll take that one. You have a pending motion right now that sets the rate at 50 cents per 1,000 gallons. That's a substantial component of the main motion. Your amendment would effectively defeat that component of the main motion. So under our rules, that's not appropriate. If you want to make that motion after this motion is made, and if
that,
it's...
That's fine. That's absolutely fine.
I'm going to second your motion. Jim Boff's motion.
Okay. Then I believe we have a motion and a second, and we should vote on the amendment first. If there's no further discussion.
I thought we're not going to do the amendment.
This is a new amendment.
My amendment about the water storage allocation.
Very good.
About the water storage, yeah.
Okay, so this is to include language regarding the water storage allocation being attempted to be gotten by both the county and the city of 65%. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
That passes unanimously.
4-0.
4-0 with Commissioner Amos being recused.
Mr. Chairman, if you're going to ask for a call on the main motion, can I have confirmation from the maker and the second that it is time critical?
Yes. Yeah. Thank you. It's time sensitive. Time critical.
Sorry, Mr. Chairman.
And I think that if it passes, we need to think about another meeting before the end of the week.
Okay, so if there's no further discussion, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. Aye.
Aye.
That ties 2-2.
So those of you that vote against it, do you have a proposal?
Yeah, I'd like to hear the proposal.
Well, I like essentially what we've got, but at around the 20 cents level for the raw water. I mean, do this. Tim, can you change the number to a 10 cents where we've got the 50 cents?
I mean,
where's
let's think about, just for a moment, please, that we
have
already rejected
the proposal. Let him tell you.
I'm talking to him right now.
If you have a proposal, let him tell you. Let him do.
Okay, so that's almost a third. That's a $27 million number.
Plus seven. It's 35 million.
$35 million swing.
Well, from the current offer, but it's 27 less than what we would currently be paying.
Okay, go up there and put a zero up there. And see what it says.
Well, we don't pay zero now, so I wouldn't want to do less.
But can I ask you?
And my point is that, you know, we're talking about over 10 years. You know, $13 million difference. I don't know why, you know, we can't talk about this a little bit.
Can you explain that?
Because you're showing it's not a real savings, that's why.
Can you explain to me, please? I'm not challenging, I just, if they've already rejected 30 cents,
why do
we think they're going to accept 20?
Well, when we offered 20, why did they think we would accept 50? We offered them 20. Why would they possibly counter with 50 since we offered them 20?
They countered with 50 and a bill for $11.4 million and two tiers, and
it cost us
$7.5 million.
Yeah. So, gentlemen, if you will, just for a moment, when we gave 30 cents on the last offer, it was calculating in paying for the infrastructure. Of that was 20 cents of the 30 cents. So, if you give them a straight 20 cents, you give them an increase over your last offer.
Well, they They sent a proposal over here that would have increased our costs $7.5 million over 10 years.
You're doing a little.
And then now we've come back with a proposal that saved us 15.
Well, saved us, yeah. I mean, they could have sent one over here that says, just send in your, you know, your firstborn.
Okay. Can I make a motion, please?
And, you know, who knows what they could have sent over here. The savings you get isn't based on what they necessarily sent over here.
No, it's not the savings on what he sent over here. It's the savings that we currently pay.
Well, no, you started with this, with the other number.
Okay, they're both $7 million.
Mr. Chairman, could we pause for getting back on the line? I mean, I feel like he's about to make a motion. He needs to hear this part of the discussion.
Sandy, thank you.
Hey, we're
back again.
Yeah.
We sort of been quiet, relatively speaking, we've been quiet since we lost you, so.
Me too.
Brian, you were saying something, I think?
Yeah. I was just trying to point out that this saves us $7 million off the current contract, correct, Commissioner?
$7.5 million
off the current contract over 10 years, and then this saves us, and this is also $7.5 million less offer than what they proposed.
So you already said that about 5 or 6 times today.
Oh, okay.
It's not a true savings. It's all big. Look. It seems, it looks like we're going to be a stalemate unless we go along with your offer, what it looks like.
Well, Todd, I do have to ask you this.
No, just make a reasonable.
If can you give us an idea where you think the smoke and mirrors
is?
Yeah,
I want to see the smoke and mirrors.
I know it's very hard because you can't see the spreadsheet and whatnot.
Because you guys are saying raise up the raw water by 500% and it's going to save us money.
I think Moshe's been trying to teach
you how to
negotiate.
Well, hang on a minute. That is certainly true. What we're saying is we have a spreadsheet here.
What you're looking at a spreadsheet, Mr. Boff, is this. When you level your 1.2 billion gallons down, instead of that buying the 1.6 off what we do now, even if your dollar amount that you pay, it's still going to show a saving. Because you're then throwing in there that you're going to buy an additional 6 million a day, half raw, half finished. But that's not on the spreadsheet, which would raise the numbers right back up there again.
Excuse me, you're not required to buy that.
It's not being shown.
You're not required to buy it.
But it will happen and you know it will. And that's where the smoke and mirrors are coming in.
If you're required to buy it, then you're also selling it. You're only buying it if you need it. So if you're selling it, you're recouping the margin on it. This is just that they guarantee to make it available to us.
Are you showing the possibility of when we actually do buy that extra water? Be putting it in there, Commissioner Thomas, if you didn't think we're actually going to need it, actually going to buy it.
Okay, then why don't we, instead of having the $1.2 billion in finished water, keep it at $1.6 if you're absolutely sure we're going to need it?
Then you're not doing the smoke and mirrors, at least that way you think. But then once you do that, are you still going to try to get 50 cents?
I'll tell you what. Let's go down this road. If there's a possibility here, do you mind? Put that in at 1.6.
You typed that number before.
Every year.
It might not be.
Okay, so now go over to the right, if you don't mind, and put the raw water, just go ahead and put the raw water at 40. Put the raw water at 40.
That's correct.
Okay, so, can you go over to the right? Hold on, we're working the spreadsheet. We're plugging your numbers in. Hold on just a second.
I'm going to ask this one, so I'm going to do that if you don't mind. Mr. Boff, how do you feel about sticking with the old 1.6 if they do the 2.25? Okay. Stick with our 10 cents or 14 cents or 12 cents on the raw. I say 0.7. But I want the raw to go 20 years, and we need to go with the finish on a 5.5. Do the raw water now. You have, how did you get 46? Where's, I'm looking at on the far left. Why does it say 46?
Well, because that's column eight. Back up to the top a little bit.
46
that's,
right there.
Yeah, let's look at that.
That's, isn't that inclusive in the other columns?
Okay. Yeah. Raw water. Okay. You started 45. Base raw water. 40. Okay. Now 40. Take that to 35.
What are you doing?
I'm just.
We're just working.
I'm trying to get. Here. I'm trying to get to the $7.5 million savings and show you what it would be. That doesn't.
Went the wrong way.
Went the wrong way, didn't I?
Get off the savings thing.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Because it's not a real savings thing.
Okay.
Good
there we go. Now we go to 45.
You're only paying 10 cents now. How are you saving it 35 cents?
40.
What's that say, 62 or 82?
Go to 42.
60.
.425.
There you go.
All right, Todd, you're right.
What?
1.6 at the 225 and then 42 and a half cents on the raw.
How much? 42 cents on the raw?
Yeah.
What I'm trying to get at, gentlemen, is you just raised up the amount on finish to what we buy now.
No, we didn't.
That's the savings.
A savings?
Well, you said we were going to use.
Say it's not a savings.
It is a savings. It is a savings.
Forsyth, it's not a savings. You just raised it. You guys are playing this number so terrible.
It's a savings over the current contract.
Go ahead and go to full month. The 250 a thousand and the 1.6 billion.
250?
250 a thousand and 1.6 billion on finish.
All right, so we go back to what we buy on raw times 10 cents, which is exactly what we do today. 250 on the finish, gotta fix that. And how much on raw? 10 cents. 10 cents, what's the pay today? 10.3.
Okay.
That's 21 million.
$21 million. What's the word? Savings. So the goal with the contract that we have today. Okay. 21 million savings over your savings. Okay, so what about?
Well, we got to pay the 11.4.
What about paying the 11.4?
Oh, let's just go to the check for that for 65% ownership.
They're not giving up ownership, Todd.
Well,
I mean, you got to get that. You got to get that in here.
I thought we weren't talking about infrastructure anymore.
Well, if we leave it at the current contract, we have to pay the 11.4 like the chairman put it to a couple of years ago.
This is 21 million savings. Yours was 7 million. What's the difference
in
those two numbers, gentlemen? 14?
For what? If we pay the 11?
We have to be able to treat it all
on the phone. I'm just trying to see where yours came in.
Well, it'd be.
And they're getting paid for their infrastructure.
It'd be a $10 million savings. It'd be a $10 million savings.
Not savings.
It is savings. Except we're also on the hook if anything breaks or anything else. So we just have to hope everything's status quo. Because we have risk with that. Is that your motion?
I mean, every time you have to look yourself in the mirror, you get the savings thing down.
Well, I'm just trying to incorporate all the facts, Todd, not just part of it.
And that's what I'm doing, too, and I'm seeing it all in the savings.
Well, I don't know if you can see it or not, because I'm looking at the spreadsheet that shows it.
Can get us told in 21, going back to full boat contract.
No, because we...
It was only seven.
Because we have to pay the 11.4 if we go forward, like the chairman agreed to a couple of years ago.
Well, then write him a check for 11.4. Let's keep it separated and clean. And that's what I mean by smoking marijuana. Let it be out there exactly what everything is for.
Is that your motion?
Okay, do I want ownership on that body?
No, I said, is that your motion?
No, wait a minute. Just because he says something, don't jump on him and say, is that
your
motion?
I'm just asking him if that's what he wants
to do. He knows how to make a motion if he wants to make a motion.
What do you want us to do, Todd? 250 and 10.3, just like it is now.
If we did that, we're going to go 5 and 5.
Okay.
But I want a 20-year on a raw 10 cents.
Okay. Well, 10 cents with CPI.
Yeah,
it's fine. Okay. And what about the 11.4?
You're going to have that. Counselor, can you hear me okay?
Counselor, yes.
He's nodding.
Mr. Gerard, can you step closer? When you talk, I have a very, very hard time hearing you.
Okay. What do you need, Commissioner?
If we pay the 11.4... And the full amount of the invoice, how do you want to word that? What's the form?
With the objective being what? That we receive a 65% ownership interest in the infrastructure?
Well, if you don't say put the word ownership, then what do you want to do is put in there? Make sure we're
covered.
How do you want to word stuff?
Capacity. 65%.
Well, we've made multiple offers on this before. We've made an offer that was based upon ownership. And if that's not on the table, then the next, we talked about, in the last IGA we sent over, we talked about a leasehold interest.
Well, why don't we put anything? Why don't we just say we're paying your invoice? At the 65% of your invoice reads?
Well, the invoice was an offer in itself. I mean, if you looked at that invoice, it contained language that said, if you pay X, you get Y. I actually, since y'all want to hear my opinion, I mean, I like the notion of, if we're going to pay flat out for that amount, I want the notion of getting a guaranteed increase in our permit allocation over and above the existing permits, plus the percentage in the storage allocation to the extent that ever becomes available to us. I mean, that,
of course.
To me, that's better than ownership.
And use of that for the lifetime of that infrastructure, of that income. Lifetime of it. Because we just paid our share of it.
You can craft it where that survives the agreement. I mean, you can do it that way.
Mm-hmm. And gentlemen, that'd be the way I'd be interested in doing that, even if we don't get ownership. What would you allow to use it for the lifetime of it? Because he's asked us to pay for it at 65% of it. And you do, if you have to go to your $1.6 billion and you're clean and you're not doing $1.2 plus another $6 daily, which is another way of getting there. At least you're clean and you're dry and there's no confusion going on. I'd rather spend $2.25, and but I want to spend the 10 cents on the roll.
I don't think.
I know you don't fight, but you talk, you're working on a deal.
You're full of wittyisms today, there.
So, see, what I'm getting at, Commissioner Bell, is the threat that he may raise it by 1,000% on the draw of the city, Mike, or the threat that it may go back to a standard contract, is not such a threat on a standard contract, because it shows by your work, $21 million savings over your offer of $7 million
savings. Well, it's not $21 million savings. You're using smoke and mirrors now, because you got to pay 11.4.
That needs to be paid
separately. All right, let me ask you. Doesn't matter. Still cash out of the taxpayer's
pocket. Yeah, Todd, the spreadsheet included...
It included that payment. I got you.
Yeah.
So it leaves about $14 million left for the intake payment. And I guess that's what you're doing over the 10 years. Is that correct?
Right. Now, Todd, what is your idea that, you know, one advantage to not doing the $11 million is you don't have to pay for it all at once. You're paying for it over time.
I don't want to spend the 10 cents. And there's good reason for that. If you guys, you may end up with additional permits. You can get more raw want, that then want to buy today, and that calculation will save you the most money by running all that raw water through their water plant. And the little bit of money you're going to pay difference on buying the 1.2 to 1.6 at 225 or 250 won't prepare the difference of us, you know, treat all that extra water ourselves.
Okay, let's be clear.
Over time and over the years.
Let's be clear on the savings, though, because we don't want to use smoke and mirrors. If you put the 11.4 back in there,
it's 10.
Okay, we save 10. And the only way we can save 10 is if we stop buying finished water after 5 years. That's the only way you save 10. Otherwise, if you're just renewing the existing contract, then the costs are the same.
Put in
11.4. He's working the spreadsheet. Just be patient for just a second. Put in 11.4 as one big payment, not 1.1.
Okay.
Just put it in there. 11.4 year one.
I hear what you're saying, Commissioner Tam.
Okay.
But at the end of 5 years, if we don't have additional permits, we don't have anything, we're still going to be buying it from them. You're still going to have to buy finished water or something from the city. I don't ever see that go away completely.
Okay, then why don't we do, if you're going to do that, why not lock it down? Because you're talking as if in 5 years, they're going to they're still going to have the ability to sell it to us.
Well, you're going to go 5 and 5, and you should shoot for a 20 on the raw. And those should be the term limits. Now you got to figure out what you're going to put in there and do in those term limits.
All right, so Tim, just go back over to the left, if you don't mind, just for a little bit. So if what you're saying is you're going to go along with renewing the existing contract, paying $11.4 million, 5 year on the finish.
I was trying to compare it to y'all, seeing how much savings there really was. It sounds like it's apples for apples compared to what we're doing today.
But the savings, be clear on the savings, that the savings are if and only if you don't have to buy finished water after year five. That's the only place there's a savings in what you said. But if that's your motion, I'll second it.
No, it's not my motion. Oh. I'm saying I'm good yet.
I'm sorry. I thought you were saying pay the 11.4 and take it to 250 and take it to 10 cents. I thought that's what you were saying.
I was wanting you to see the numbers out there so you could
okay. Well, I've seen them before because that's where it came to the board in 2006, 2008, 2009, and 2010. And didn't pass. So do you want to do this?
Actually, it did pass. It was rejected.
Passed 3-2 or 4-1?
Don't know.
I guess you don't want to vote on that. Is that something worth entertaining? Do you? Okay.
However, I'm confused. I am confused about the 5-year 10%. The comparison of the two numbers, when you had 50 cents up there, was that for 10 years or 5 years?
50 cents was for 10 years at the raw one.
Okay, and he's put 10 cents up there for 5 years?
No, he put 10 cents up there for five, but what he's saying is, see, there it goes. Did I say five? He put it for 10 years. See, he's got it on there for 10 years, but the savings is over the left.
Back here one more time.
Under the purchase finished water
your
from
car.
The city. Right there. Right there is where the savings is, because it assumes that you don't have to buy any more finished water.
You got to save the 10 cents on raw.
Okay, I see what you're saying.
So that's why he has a savings.
If you're going in five, your 10 cents is going to save you tremendously.
That's right.
You end up in court by accident and got to be here on 10 cents.
Why would you end up in court? I think this is what they'd offered us years ago.
Because it doesn't sound like you and Mr. Bell want to vote.
I just said I'd second your motion if that's your motion. Didn't I?
You did.
Okay, so is that your motion?
See, we're going to go all the way back to we're not countering the cities. My first motion
it is a counter.
Decline accepting the offer from the city. That's my first motion.
Second. We have a motion and a second.
Just to confirm, it'd be time sensitive. Again, this would be, you know, manifested in a letter to the city.
Todd, is your motion time sensitive on this?
Time sensitive.
Thank you.
Okay, and second, again, for time sensitive, to reject the city's offer that we just received. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Todd, did you say?
Yeah, aye.
Okay, that passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos. Do you have another motion, Todd?
Yeah, now it can be clean. We don't have to get in all that stuff dissecting your matters.
Okay.
So if I miss anything in here, help me out from our last discussions. If we have to, I want to stick with the $225,000.
You just said 250.
All right, but listen, $225,000.
Well, you're changing it then.
We're going to buy the $1.6 billion as we need it.
As we need it? You mean no commitment?
No. Well, there'll be a commitment. We're going to buy it throughout the year, but we can buy it on the months that we need it. Doesn't have to buy it in the winter months.
I think that's the way it is now.
That's $1.6 billion annual commitment.
Billion, yes.
Okay.
And 10 cents per thousand on the raw.
You report purchasing per day.
All right.
And you pay, and that's one motion, because we're going to do a separate one for the intake.
And I think that you also have to include, we pay, what, $4,500 a month on the current?
We're not going to do that. What are you talking about?
It's in the 10 cents.
Yeah, that's what the 10 cents goes to.
Commissioner Levent, what are the durations of each of these?
Additional fees that go with our 10 cents per thousand.
It's five-year option, right? On the finished?
Five renewal on the finished.
Okay.
A minimum of 20 on the raw. Am I missing anything to cover us?
Sure.
On a separate motion.
Why do you want to do it on a separate motion?
I'm
sorry, you can do it on this. Okay. Point.
Right.
We have the use of that capacity 65%. We're going to pay the invoice for the intake, but we use the capacity of the 65%, and it will increase as permits increase, along with the capacity of the storage area for the poor and EPD. For the price that's on the invoice for the life of the structure.
Does that include the water storage allocation?
Yes, and before the life of the structure and tower.
Todd, you just keep adding and changing to it as we're going along here.
Well, because I want to make sure life of the structure is clarified somehow.
But you keep adding to the motion as you go.
No, it's his motion.
I'm done.
Okay,
I'm gonna go ahead.
I'm sorry, I thought you said I'm going to.
I'm gonna offer up an amendment that they make available. At our request, $6.5 million daily on
dollars. Actually, I'll go for that.
You've caught it.
You sneaky rascal.
Smoke mirrors. 6.5 million gallons a day, 50-50 raw finished at our request on a 30-day average.
Can you tell me why we just raised up the amount we're buying?
So we got plenty of water.
So we have enough water. We're not committed to buying it.
It is raised from $1.2 billion to $1.6 billion to cover that for you. So why are you throwing in there again?
Yeah, and I got to ask you this. If you're saying that that's at our request?
No, you said that's committed. I'm saying it is.
Yeah, you don't have to buy in the winter month. If we need to buy $10 million on a summer month, we can.
That's fine.
But not in the winter if we don't need to. So why do you want it? I don't understand.
Okay, then let me try to explain it to you, since you don't understand. Okay. It's at our request, which means we don't have to buy it if we don't need to, but that they have it available to us.
Okay.
Okay, now, here's the problem I have with that. How will they know the difference between our request and if we get the intake expand, permit expanded?
We don't make the request.
For raw.
Then we don't make the request.
So it's just, but we're going to be taking the same amount of water potentially.
But we'd be paying the same amount of money for it.
No. Let's say the intake is expanded and we take more water that month.
Not expanded, it's the allocation.
The permit is expanded.
Okay.
Increased for us. And we take more water, which is the equivalent to the amount that you're saying here.
Okay.
And they say, well, you took more water. And we say, well, that's because we were permitted to take it. And they say, no, in the contract, if you take it, you got to pay us for it. Pay us extra for it.
Plus, I'm not saying pay extra for it. Plus, if we get our permits increased, it's a 50-50, we have to buy finished when all we really need is to buy raw. And it's hooking us into buying more finished. And that's the part I don't like about it.
Todd?
Yeah.
You're coming dangerously close to not having enough water.
No, you're not. I just made you could buy additional raw. I just gave you your additional finished by raising it from 1.2 to 1.6.
I'm just going to say it again. You're coming dangerously close to not having enough water. I'm going to withdraw my second, or my amendment.
I tell you what, Mr. Ball.
Yes.
Why don't you redraw your second? Knowing that he's going to throw that in there, I'm going to redo my motion.
Okay, I withdraw my second.
All right, I'm going to redo my motion. My motion is to buy 1.2 billion gallons annual basis. Buying it on the days that we need it for 225 a thousand. The raw water is 10 cents per thousand, and the intake structure, we paid the invoice of 11.4 and the change that it shows on there, including any additional, the 65% capacity, any additional permits for EPDM to go for, and that the city will go with us and ask for additional permits and work to get those. And that's my motion.
Mr. Perkins, do you think we have enough water?
No, now you can add yours in there to get the additional water.
No, that's
he doesn't have
I
a second.
Well, first of all, second.
Now, Mr. Tam, would you like to add your amendment to it?
Well, Tim, could you answer his question?
We need to be assured to get the additional water. That would assume what we've cut on the finished, we have to be able to treat that at our plant. So we have to have the ability to treat that extra above our current permit for that amount. So we have to get that expanded permit to do that. And
why don't you just
gets us to where we are today. So, and then as we grow, either in raw water or finished water, we're going to have a need some days for possible.
Gentlemen, did you guys, did Mr. Tam and Mr. Bell not vote just a moment ago on a 2.2 billion plus the 6 million a day split between raw and finished, and you thought that was enough, and now all of a sudden you don't, and it's my motion?
No, I think Brian did add a kicker after some of this for more water.
I know he did, on top of the 1.2. And now that I've offered the 1.2, his kicker, he says, won't be enough now.
No, he's just not making the motion now.
Okay, I'm waiting for it.
So Tim, what would be a reasonable thing to add to this?
We need to have the assurance to
1.6?
That we get to treat the additional water. For this to work, we've got to be able to get up to this. You see this big increase here after 5 years when we're no longer getting that water. We've got an increased amount we have to treat daily here, and this is all assuming that we're going to get to treat that extra water, whether it's some of the city's intake capacity at our plant. If you drop this down below the 1.6, is the way we're doing it now during summer months, sometimes I get 6.5 million gallons a day from it on a 30-day average. So we're going to need 6.5 million gallons a day from the city just to meet current demands, either finished or raw.
Todd?
Todd. Todd.
All I'm trying to say, if we drop less than current amounts, we have to be able to get extra raw water to our plant.
See, we're saving money by not buying enough water. That's what we're doing, but we're not going to have enough water. We're saving money, everybody. Yeah.
But we don't have enough water.
But we don't have enough water. What is he doing? It's like he's walking. What are you doing, Todd?
Hang on.
I hope you're not having a tornado. Sounds like hail.
I'm sorry, I'm back.
Okay. Todd, we've come close to believing that we don't have enough water here. Tim just said...
We're not close. We don't have enough water.
Because our raw water permits need to be increased.
City Cumming doesn't control that, Todd.
I understand they don't. But didn't you guys, are you going to add some verbiage in there that they'll sell some of their raw water side, or 50-50?
Whatever you want to add, Todd, just go ahead and make the motion.
Well, when I raised it up a minute ago to buy more finished, 1.6, then y'all want to add on top of that again.
Todd, I was never adding to it. I was just saying at our option in case we needed it. I never added to it. It was only if we needed it.
Don't you want to just buy raw from them after we buy that much finished?
I don't want to buy 1.6 million gallons of finished water. I want to buy 1.2 and then have the additional available should we need it.
Okay, that's fine. So I did the 1.2 in my last motion. It's been a second. If you'd like to respectfully add that to it as amendment, that's perfectly fine. I'll go along with it.
Why don't you just add it part of your motion? I don't even know what your motion is, to be honest.
The motion is purchase 1.2 billion of finished water annually, 225 per thousand gallons, 5-year initial term, 5-year renewal. Raw waters, the 10 cents per thousand gallons. I didn't say it, but I would assume it was 20-year term.
20-year term, Todd?
It was 5 and 5 on finished, and it was 20 on raw.
$11,400,000 outright for the intake with a commitment for 65% of future EPD permanent allocation, 65% storage allocation in Lake Union.
Todd, do you remember in one of these marathon sessions that we've had before that we've been told that a payment of $11.4 million out of the Water and Sewer Authority will jeopardize our capital improvement? Do you remember that?
I've also heard them say it would on a one-on-one conversation.
Well, will it jeopardize our capital improvement plan? Tim?
Sorry.
If we pay $11.4 million, will it or will it not? I mean, I just remember you said it would jeopardize. We'd have to rework our capital improvement plan.
I was told there was nine.
We're carrying nine in there, in the CIP.
We carry $9 million in there?
Yes, we put nine in there. So that would be the same. I think we had concerns about having to capitalize payments in a year in an operational budget. Mr. Bruin could better answer the financial part of it as far as...
Because speaking of finances, I just want to do something real quick. Go back over to the finished and just carry it on down 5 more years.
This one?
1.2. Just see what that looks like.
The problem is not whether or not the 1.2 or 1.6 will give us enough. If you use it in your summer months and your hot months and you need it, it is enough. But when you're forced to buy it in the winter months, leaving your late spring, summer, and early fall, it's a short shift.
Todd, that any of the finished water can be taken down as we need it.
Well, tell me how many gallons that is a day if you do it in 180 days.
Well, I don't think we need to get into trying. I think it's dangerous to try to determine when we may or may not need it when we can currently take it down whenever we need it.
Since I'm not there and I haven't had anybody run numbers for me yet, do you all mind telling me what 1.2 billion gallons on an annual basis is divided by 180 days. How many millions of gallons is that per day?
It's about 6 million a month, 6.5, right?
180 days.
Yeah, it's half of the 1.2 billion. Because right now our average is 12.2 right. a month. We didn't go on vacation though, Todd. We're here to work.
I'm asking 1.2 billion divided by 180 days.
180 days is 6 months.
That's your hot month. That's your months we need the extra water.
Why not put it to when we can get it whenever we need it?
That's the way we have it. The number run, Mr. Bell.
6.7. 6.66 million gallons a day.
So 6.6.
Or on top of the 14, that's only 20 to 21. That's going to be tight. I agree. So do we now go back and
why don't you just go back to the 1.6?
Sorry? Why can't we put a clause in there just so additional raw water? Like we did on smaller offers.
Well, we the 6.5 million was 50-50. We could make it either or, except I'll tell you what let's do, Todd. I got an idea. Put it back at 1.6, and ask them to make us a condition that they make available an additional 6.5 million gallons a day on a 30-day average of raw water.
So you're
going to
raise it up from 1.6 to. I mean, 1.2 to 1.6, and put in the 6 million
a
day on top of that again.
Yeah.
That is what.
It's 6.5 of raw. I said raw. 6.5 of raw minimum.
Oh, that works.
1.6. So that's 1.6.
And
they make available an additional 6.5 million gallons a day on a 30-day average of raw water.
Off of their permit.
I don't care whose permit it's off of.
Listen, you can't tell them to make available. They're already making our 14 available. You're asking them to change it, or is it going to be addition to our 14 permit?
I got the 1.6 million.
Go ahead. Hold on.
1.6 million, 10 years. 225, so where did we start?
Five, I don't know. That's what he said.
And then,
five.
And then, well, it was show five or show 5 or show 10 here?
Show 10.
10 cents?
It's actually 10. I guess so.
It's actually 10.3 and a half cents.
10.8.
10.8, 10.3, something like that. What is it?
You better just put in 10.8 so we don't have to come back and go through this.
That's fine.
That way we'll have less accurate smoke and mirrors.
Oh, look at that. We're saving $7.5 million.
Same thing.
It's the same thing.
That's because I get caved in and I give you your money.
No, well, let's just go to pay the 11, so it'll cost us 3.
Is the 11 in there?
No.
Okay.
So when we do that, Todd, and pay the 11, it's costing us $3 million more than what we're doing now.
Is that what you want to do, Todd?
It's the 20-year water deal. You calculated it over 20 years?
No, that's...
still shutting it down at 10 annual numbers.
That's 10.
Come up with that difference.
That's 10.
All right, well, of course, if you wean yourself off of the finished water...
Correct.
You're going to have a reduction. But that's the unknown. Correct. That's the unknown. You just don't know...
That's why I want to do 5 and 5. You may be able to wean yourself off of 5. But if you can't, you need the water, you've got the available additional 5-year deal. So if you add it into your numbers, yes, it's going to show it.
Just so I'm clear on what you want to make sure that they keep the plant operational, equipped, and staffed if we want to use it.
No, they're going to need finished water no matter what.
We need to keep ours.
Right. I mean, tell me what days they won't need finished
water. They are going to need finished water, but they're going to need that additional 4.5 million gallons a day.
Well, how would we know that?
The city.
If we go to buy water from Cherokee County, what do they want from us? They want us to invest in their infrastructure. right? That's the only way we get water from.
Pay a higher price if you don't.
And you pay a higher price.
You can get it without a higher price, or you can pay capital and get it for a lower price.
But we're willing to do that. It's okay.
It's okay.
This is painful for another 2 hours.
Okay, I'm going to make a motion, Todd. I'm going to help us all out here, okay?
Commissioner Tam, just one second. Cindy, where are we? We have a motion and second on the table.
We have a motion and second on the floor.
Okay, and that is for what?
I believe it was for $1.2 billion on an as-needed basis, $225 per thousand, five-year renewal, 10 cents per thousand for 20 years on raw, pay 11.4 for the intake with the 65% allocation. That's on the table right now. Your 6.5, 30-day average is not part of that motion.
Right.
So that's the motion and second on the table right now.
I didn't hear real good. Don't you read back mine? Is that what you're doing?
Yes, sir. That's right.
Todd, if you'll think about withdrawing your motion, I'll make one that you might like.
Okay, my motion is withdrawn.
Now, the second needs to withdraw their second.
I withdraw it.
Thank you.
My second withdrawn motion is withdrawn.
Okay, I'm going to make a motion that we renew the contract, finished water contract as is, resetting the price down to $225.
How long are you renewing it for, please?
5 years with a five-year option.
On the finished?
On the finished water.
Okay, on finished water, okay.
That we pay the $11.4 million.
Mm-hmm.
That we pay the, or that we do the raw water at 10.8 cents a thousand.
Okay.
Well, just go ahead. Let's just be clear that it's 10.8 based on what it's really our percentage
of the wheeling fee
of the total.
We understand that. We discussed that a bunch.
Okay. Timmy, is 10.8, you think that's accurate?
It changes every month, so I mean, you know, but that's what they've been at for a few months. Average, the current contract's up and down.
Yeah,
that's going to get you in the ballpark.
That they make available 6.5 million gallons a day, and I don't know, will that fit in their permit, Tim? Will that fit in their permit?
Well, it depends on how much they need.
Hold on just a second. Will that fit in there?
I don't know. I don't know what their max days are. They've been giving us.
Yeah, but the 6.5 is a 30-day average.
Yeah, but look, how can they commit, if all of a sudden they need a lot of water, how can they commit to the 6.5?
Because the language we've always used is so long as it doesn't.
If it's including this 1.628 billion, if that...
Then we don't need 6.5. Is that what you're saying?
That would be, you know, about six, at times during this we get 6.5 from, maybe 7 occasionally, but...
Yeah, but not 6.5 more.
Your question,
not they probably cannot do 6.5 more.
Your question, will that eat into their allocation?
Okay, so what he's saying, I think, is that's 4.5 million a day. We need another 2 million a day. Is that right?
To get us to what we're doing today, and then raw water addition, yes.
So if I'm hearing you correctly, we need to ask them to make available to us another 4.5. We'd be comfortable with that, if I'm understanding that correctly.
I think so, yes.
So, Todd, you see we took it down a little because we're buying more finished.
On top of this,
I understand.
So, my motion then is that they make available an additional 4.5 million per day of raw water available to us.
Okay.
Okay.
And it's over and above our permit, right?
Yeah.
It needs to be clear that they're over and above our permit.
Well, yeah, if they're making it available to us, it's their permit.
Okay.
All right, but we're guaranteeing the 1.6.
We're buying 1.6.
We're guaranteeing it.
Yes.
Okay.
We're guaranteeing it. And that this be on the raw 15 and a 15-year option.
On the raw 15 and 15?
Yep.
5 and 5 on the finished?
Yep.
Okay.
That's my motion.
And is that
CPIU
on both or not?
Yes.
A time-sensitive commission?
Time-sensitive. Call the meeting tomorrow, the next day, Friday. I don't care.
Second.
Jim, you get it? You understand it?
Yeah. I'll say this. Currently, the contract, we can't renew the current one without a 4% cap on the CPIU, because the current one has a 4% cap per year on the CPIU.
Well, that's fine.
Okay, so you take that CPI stuff off that's already in the contract.
That's part of the as-is, is in the existing contract.
That's in the contract.
Do we want to consider?
Hold on just a second. The CPI is in my motion, and the 4.5, if that makes him comfortable, can be in my motion too.
And I'll second that.
Well, I thought your motion was to finish water as-is under the existing contract, but 5 and 5.
But what, well, as-is under the existing contract has a CPI.
Contains CPI, that's what I'm saying.
With a 4% cap.
But he wants a 4% cap.
No, the CP, the current contract has a 4% cap.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah. No objection there.
That's fine. Do we want to consider, preserve some of the cash on hand, of trying to figure out how to add something and let it?
Listen, if this is what it takes, yeah. This is what it takes.
Todd?
Yes.
You think you understand the motion?
I do. Are we 1.2 or 1.6?
1.6.
So can I ask one question, please? Earlier, the first motion the gentleman made was 1.2 with the additional 6.5. How come then that was enough water and now it's not?
Oh, he is hung up on that. He's going to sit here and answer that.
No, I'm not. Just asking what the difference is.
Sure.
Your motion now.
Because it's...
What made you realize all of a sudden there wasn't enough?
That's a fair question.
I don't know that it... Okay. We went from 1.2 to 1.6.
No. Earlier, your first motion, respectfully, was for 1.2, and you ran the additional 6.5, was it not?
Yes.
Okay, that was going to be enough water then. Now it's not enough water unless you do the 1.6 with the 6.5 million additional.
I didn't say 6.5, Todd.
No?
No. I said 4.5, and I said make it all wrong.
Oh, got you. Okay, very good. I got it.
There was no smoke, no mirrors.
Gotcha. Thank you.
Didn't I?
Yep.
Yeah. Somebody's nodding their head. That's a good sign.
Yeah,
that means vote for it, Todd.
I can't see them, though. It's like I'm blind.
Cindy wants you to vote for it.
We didn't go on vacation, Todd.
She's just about done with her book.
Yeah. We have a motion, I believe.
And a second.
And we have a second. And I guess I'll...
And what are we doing on the 11.4?
It's in there.
We're paying it. Because that's what you want to do.
Yes.
It's not yes.
Because you're in Kansas.
But we have lifetime access, correct?
Lifetime.
In the motion?
That was lifetime.
That wasn't in the motion. Lifetime.
We need to get that in the motion. We have lifetime access.
How do you go lifetime access? How do you go from 10 years to lifetime or 15 years to lifetime access?
You're losing me on this one.
Okay, when you were at 20 years, were you at lifetime access?
He was.
I'm not asking for ownership, but for painting for 65% of the infrastructure redo.
Let's
we can have access to for lifetime.
All right.
For that 65%.
And your motion, Todd, your motion did not contain the language about the permit allocations.
It's in.
Aye.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
that's a good.
That's the Cam's motion. Mine's gone.
That would be the yada yada yada.
Okay. No,
that's a given, Todd. Those permit allocation language, that's a given.
Okay, I didn't understand that, Commissioner. Did you hear that?
Well, as long as you believe the motion can be done, you'll have a given.
Well, now that it's been said on the record, I'm comfortable adding that. Yes.
Excellent. Thank you.
So you're comfortable seconding that, Patrick? We might be getting somewhere, Todd.
We might be getting somewhere, sir.
All right.
Motion and second.
We have a motion and a second. Todd, do you feel that you
don't know
enough to be able to vote? Todd?
Yeah.
Okay. That we have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, Please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0 with Commissioner Amos recused.
Could have done this 4 years ago.
Can we have this over there by noon?
We'll have it by noon tomorrow.
So when are we going to have our celebration crackers with cheese and
After they accept it.
After
they accept it. So that's just a small little component.
Fine, we get one free as holy.
All right, let's. Todd, are you going to stay on, or are you going to?
Todd and Todd.
I may lose you. We're coming in another bad area soon, but I'll try. Okay.
Okay, then let's go on to item number 2.